Hello everyone, today we are going to learn how to create this form using HTML CSS and then how to save the data after clicking the save button into MySQL database using PHP. So let's get started. I'm using VS Code for this project. You can use your own code editor. I've already opened a folder named HTML form. Let's create a file form.html. In this HTML, in the VS Code there is a shortcut for HTML file that make life a lot easier. Let's give it a title, HTML form. Now let's keep the form into a container div so that you can apply styles later. So let's put the form, and in this case the method will be post because you are sending a post request to the server. I'll get back to the action later. Let's add the fields now. And we can keep the fields into a parent div named form group. The first field, we can use a first name, and the type will be a text field. So type is text. And the name is important because we will use it in the PHP file as reference. So you should keep attention to the name. Now let's create another field. You can just copy and paste. The second field, we can put last name. So the name, last name, and the placeholder last name. Now let's copy again for the third field. So for the third field we can add email, so the type would be email in this case, and the placeholder is also email. Type is email, placeholder email. Now let's copy and paste for the fourth field. So for the fourth field, actually we need a different field. So for the fourth field, we can use a drop down list. So you can use anything. In this case, I'm using color, like favorite color. So let's give it a name, color, and let's put all the option now. As the first option, you'll just put the instruction, choose color. So for this, there will not be any value because the value will be saved to the database. So for the instruction, there will not be any value, it is empty. But for other options, we will add the values. So as a second option, we can keep red maybe. Actually, you can put anything here. So I'm putting red, green and blue for the other options. Let's just copy and paste red, green, blue, and we'll have to put the values accordingly. Red, green and blue. You can put anything you want. Now lastly, what we need is we need a button. So in this case the type will be submit. And this is the button that you will click to save the data into the database. The name should be submit. So that is it. That's the part of this HTML. Now let's see how it looks. So I put the file in the jump folder. Inside the jump folder, there is another folder called stdocs. So you'll have to put the file inside here. And yes, so we'll have to run it through localhost, then the name of the folder. So localhost, then name of the folder, and then name of the file. So this is how it looks. Now, if you guys don't know how to use JAM to run PHP program, then I have another video on my channel that just check it out. So this is how it looks without CSS. Now we'll have to port the actual CSS. So let's get into it. We can use Bootstrap CDN for the CSS. So let's write Bootstrap CDN in the browser. Then click on the first link. So we'll have to copy the CSS part, the HTML one. Let's copy and put it into the head tag. And now we'll have to put the class name accordingly so that it gets the style of Bootstrap. So for the fields, the class name is form control. Let's write form control and copy for other input field. So form control. form control, and for the select tag, form control, and lastly the button. So now we'll have to put some our own style. Let's keep it into the head tag. We are not using any extra CSS file. So let's make the container centered and add some padding and margin. Let's give it a max width of 600 pixels and margin 0 auto, and also padding, some padding 50 pixels and then margin 0 auto. This will make the container centered, centered vertically. Now let's add some padding into the body tag, padding 40 pixels. Now let's add some margin to the form group, to the input field, margin bottom 30 pixels. So now let's see how it looks in the browser. Okay, we can give some style to the button. So that is also from Bootstrap. So button info is a class name for the buttons that will make it nicer. Let's see how it looks. It's looking really nice now. Now the last part and the most important part is to save the data after clicking the submit button using PHP to the MySQL database. So let's get into it. So firstly, we'll have to create a database. For creating database, we'll have to go to the phpMyAdmin. So localhost and then phpMyAdmin. Now let's create new. Let's click new. So the name should be register, or you can put anything else you want. Let's click create. So we are putting 5 fields because we'll need an extra field for the ID. Then the table name is users. So ID should be integer and auto increment. Primary key also. First name is varchar. Varchar means variable character. So for the string that is not too big, we put varchar. So let's put it for all other fields. So the length can be 30, 20 based on your requirements. Color, varchar, and 20. Let's give it 20 length. And let's save. Click save. So table, database and table is created now. Now we'll have to create the PHP file to process the data and save the data into MySQL database. Let's name it process.php. Now we'll have to put this process.php in the action. So exactly same name need to be put. So our PHP code need to be put inside the PHP tag. Now there is a variable in PHP called post, by which you can access all the data submitted by the user in the form. Now you can check what it have using the printer method. So let's check without submitting, without giving any value to the form. So what it have? It have the error items, but the error item does not have any values because we did not put any values in the form. Now let's give values and check what post variable have. So now the post variable have all the error values. So now we can access the values using the post variable. So first we'll have to check whether or not the submit button is clicked. We can check it through isSet method. Inside isSet method, we'll have to give the variable post with the array element submit. The name is submit, in the submit button. So if submit button is clicked, then we will proceed. Unless you will not proceed. So if the submit button is clicked, let's grab all the data from the submitted form. We can access that, as I said earlier, we can access that using the post variable. So you'll have to write the post variable and the array item. The array item is in this case the name we put on the form. So for the first name, we put the name is first name. Put the name first name as you remember. So it is first name. Now we can just copy for other fields. So for the last name, the name was last underscore name. And then the email, for the email, the name was email. So in the post variable, the array element will be email. Email. And then the color. For the color, the array element will be color, as you put the name as color. So that is why the name is important. I already mentioned that when I created the form. So now we'll have to check whether or not the users provided all the information. So we can check that using a function called empty. So if there is any empty variable, then we'll give a message to the user saying that we'll have to provide all the information. So we'll have to check is variable using the AND logical operator. So AND logical operator means all the condition need to be fulfilled. So we'll have to check all the variables whether or not it's empty. So we are using not empty to check to make sure that the variable is not empty. First name, then last name, then email, and then the color. So just copy. Okay, so if there is no empty value, then we will proceed. But if there is any empty value, then we will give a message to the user saying that you will need to provide all the information. So we can show message by the echo command of PHP. Now, if everything is okay, we'll have to connect to the database. To connect database, we will use MySQL connect function. So this function uses four parameters. First parameter is the host name. Second parameter is the database username. Third parameter is the database password. And the fourth parameter is the database name itself. Now for the jump, by default, the database name, okay. So for the jump software, we are using the default host name is localhost and the username is root, and it does not have any password, so the password will be empty. And the database name, we can copy it from the phpMyAdmin. So root is the username and the password, you don't have any password by default if you don't change anything in the jump configuration. So let's copy the database name, register. Let's put it. Now we can keep this return true or false. So if connection happens successfully, it will return true. Otherwise, it will return false. So let's keep it in a variable link. Now let's check what link variable has. If it has false value, that means connection is not successful. So if connection is not successful, we will die, the code execution will die here. The code execution will be stopped here. So we are using die method to do that. And in the die method, we can show the users the actual error, or MySQL connect error is the function to show the errors. Now, if everything is okay, we can continue. So now we'll have to add the command for inserting the value. So the command is inserted into, let's keep it into a variable called SQL. You can give it any name you want, but the command need to be exactly the same. So insert into the name of the table. The name of the table in this case is users. You can check, you can double check in the phpMyAdmin. Yes, it's users. Let's copy it. Now we'll have to put brackets. Inside the brackets, we'll have to put all the column names. We can also copy it from the phpMyAdmin. Insert into users and then the column name of the table. So let's just copy from the table name, from the table. So we don't need to put ID because that is auto incremented. So we'll copy from the first name. First name, last name. And then email. And the last one is color. So then we'll have to put the actual values. So in this case, the values are already stored in the variable. So we'll have to put the variable here. So the first one is first name. So we'll have to put the variable first name. Then the second name, sorry, last name. Then email. And then the color. Make sure the sequence is exactly the same as the column name, otherwise it will trigger an error. Now we'll have to execute this command. So to execute this command, we will use a function called MySQLi query. So MySQLi query can return either false or true. So if anything wrong happens, if the query is not successful, it will return false. So we'll have to check it whether it returns false or true. So we can keep it inside my if statement, if MySQL query. Inside the MySQL query function, we'll have to put the parameter, the actual command. In this case, it is a SQL variable. So if it's okay, if the query is successful, then we can show the message that record is inserted successfully. Otherwise, we can show a message that saying that something went wrong. Echo something went wrong. Okay, now let's check whether it is working or not. So let's just fill the form and then submit. There is an error actually. Okay, actually MySQL query have to have two arguments. So other one is the actual connection variable. In this case, it is link. Okay, now let's check again. I still have an error. Sorry. okay. So the link variable will be the first argument and the SQL variable will be the second argument. That was my mistake. Sorry. So let's make it correct. Let's apply the correction. So link, the connection variable will be the first argument and then the SQL command will be the second argument. Now everything should be okay. Yep, successful. Let's check the database. Yes, we have a new value, Yandelion. So everything is okay. Thank you guys for watching my video. Let me know if you have any questions in the comment. And don't forget to subscribe.